So this here would have been the main boarding hall or terminal with the control tower up there. So this would be directly facing the runway out in that direction. As with most of these places, looks a bit tattered, it's taken a bit of a beating, and the trees have taken hold here. Pretty cool contrast. Stairs, check the view from the control tower. Whoa, pretty steep. This sort of third floor was actually added after the war by the Soviet army when they took over. So here we get a good overview of the runway. So when this was built originally in the mid 1930s, it was used for sort of civilian aircraft, light personal aircraft, and yeah, there was a flight school here, and yeah, sort of like an aviation club. So imagine you lived in Berlin or the surrounding areas, and you want to come out here on the weekend and fly your little single engine plane, and you'd come out here. So when the Germans had it, it was just grass runway, and then when the Soviets took it over after the war, they mainly used it for their helicopters. So as you can see here, you have these sort of concrete slabs laid out in these circular patterns. So this is where they would have their, this would be the helipads that they used. These two towers here off to the side were also built by the Soviets. They were used for engine testing. Not really sure about the intricacies of that, but just to test, I think, mainly their helicopter engines. Thank you. Here's another section of this main boarding hall. When the Soviet army took over after the war, this was converted into a gym. See the basketball court here. Sort of a common theme when you come to these bases, it seems like. Basketball was the sport of choice for the Red Army. Oh, these floorboards are about to go. You see the different sport disciplines, badminton, what is that, some sledgehammer. And yeah, there have been some recent additions as well. So this building is the so-called final assembly hall. When this base was built in the 1930s, in 1935, there was a German aircraft, light aircraft manufacturing company that moved their production to this site. So this would have been their facilities. So up here, you probably have had administrative offices, you know, the foreman overlooking the assembly of the planes. They had quite a big production here. A few halls, obviously, was a good place. They had the runway, so they could test all their engines on their planes here. Corner office. All right, nice. just left the assembly hall for the aircraft production. Now we're just on the outskirts of the premises. Here we have the most enigmatic building of them all. Let's go inside and see what's going on in here. I think we may have approached this building a bit poorly. Let's try another entrance. See, third time's a charm. Just go head on in the front door. Oh yeah. So this building here was constructed in 1940. It has the ominous name, the Special Building. And it was used for quote unquote secret military projects by the Germans. It's probably related to aircraft manufacture. So obviously during the war, the aircraft company, like all other companies really of that nature, was put at the disposal of the German army, more specifically the German Air Force, so obviously, which is previously built small personal aircraft. Now it was sort of more geared towards building parts for the military planes instead, military aircraft. This is sort of the nick of time to come here. It's really on its last legs. Check this out. Pretty cool. Here you can see rails laid out between the buildings. So obviously used to transport the different parts and components from building to building. So the building in front of us there, that's the main hall for the aircraft company. Here we have the clandestine special building. And through the trees is where we came from earlier. That was the huge final assembly building. So we'll probably go in that order that parts were put together here, constructed here, then they were moved to the final assembly building just to be put together into final product. this is pretty cool. Small road signs. Lounge chair. You can see that it opens up considerably. Sort of divided into two sections. We get a good vantage point of those two sections that we saw earlier. This central strip here of offices, so I could overlook both sides. Make sure everyone's being productive. It's a tempting ladder. I'm just trying to see where it goes. I mean, there's this structural integrity is a bit lacking here.
On the morning of July 20th, 1944, Klaus von Stauffenberg took off from the Rangsdorf Airfield, destined for Wolf's Lair, Hitler's fortified headquarters in northern Poland. His mission? To assassinate the Führer using an explosive device. Following the ultimately unsuccessful attempt, von Stauffenberg returned to the airfield that same afternoon, unaware of the failure. He was arrested together with his co-conspirators and executed just after midnight.
These massive sliding doors. When the war broke out in 1939, or rather when the Nazis invaded Poland, the local airport in Berlin, the Berlin Tempelhof Airport, was actually moved here temporarily, sort of 6 months. And so you'd have the national carrier, German national carrier Lufthansa, would have been operating off of this runway. And out of that terminal building over here. So imagine you'd have Lufthansa aircraft out here. They'll be operating routes all across sort of continental Europe. And as far away as Athens. So yeah, this is where you would have come if you wanted to catch a flight to Stockholm, Prague, Poland. All right, so the rain is starting to come down on us. We managed to cover everything just in time. One of these places is the lack of roofs makes it hard to find shelter. But I think we got it. Hope you enjoy that one, and I'll catch you in the next one.